Hello everyone, welcome to New Wave Coaching Classes on Mathematics. This is your host Jatin. Today we are going to discuss about the areas of some parts of the circle. The parts which you have already studied in your grade 9. I'm talking about the sector of the circle and the segment of the circle. So before we talk about how we can find the area of a sector and how we can find the area of segments, let's understand again what a sector means and what a segment means, right? So let's see on the board now. So I draw a circle here. Now this is the center and I draw two radii from here. We know this portion of the circumference is called an arc. Now the region enclosed between the two radii and the arc, or we can say the area enclosed between the two radii and the arc, is basically called a sector. And we know sectors are of two types. One is minor sector and one is major sector. So when we talk about minor sectors, basically the area, if the portion is smaller than the semicircle of if it is smaller than semicircle, then we call it as minor sector. And if the area is more than semicircle, area of the semicircle, then we call it as major sector. So this one is the major one and this is the minor sector, right? Then we talk about the segment of the circle. There's another circle I have drawn. Now here I draw a chord, and you know the chord is basically a line segment which touches the circle at two points, right? So this is basically a chord, right? And the area enclosed between the chord and the arc of the circle is called the segment. Again, we talk about two segments. One is the minor segment and one is the major segment. And the area which is lesser than the area of semicircle is called as a minor segment. And the area which is more than the area of semicircle is called as the major segment, right? So this is the meaning of basically sector and segment. Now we talk about how we can find the area of a sector. So let's begin from somewhere. We know that the area of complete area is equal to pi r square. Now if I divide this complete area in two parts, that is, I am talking about the semicircle, right? Now the area of the semicircle. So area of semicircle obviously, since this is half of the circle, so I will be writing 1 by 2 pi r square, right? Again, I divide the circle in 4 parts now. So this basically becomes a quarter circle. So area of quarter circle obviously, this is 1/4 of the circle, so I write it as 1 by 4 pi r square. Now if you see carefully, here I know that I am dividing the circle in two parts, equal parts, 4 equal parts, right? But if I don't know that how many parts, equal part, does it forms, then how can I find the area? Suppose I just make this much. Now if I have to find the area of this, then how can I find, right? Now if you go back in your small classes, you learned about fractions. What fraction of this forms part of the circle, right? So what fractional part of this is of complete circle? So first of all, we have to find this area, how much fractional part of the complete area does this sector have. Now again, the question, how we can do it, right? Now we know circle is round and the complete angle inside the circle is of 360 degree, right? Now this complete angle is of This is 360 degree. Now, if we suppose that the angle formed by this sector in the center is theta, the angle which the two radii are forming when they form a sector, we suppose it as theta. It means what fraction does it forms? Now, this portion is basically will be equal to theta by 360, because this is the complete angle and this is some part, right? Now, using this fraction, I know if this was 1/4, so this becomes 1/4. This was half, so this was 1/2 pi r². Now, we have definite relation. What I can do? Area of sector. See, when I talk about sector, we will be talking about minor sector only. But when we will be talking about this, the bigger one, we will say major sector, right? But the formula remains same, only the difference will be in the value of the angle. So, area of sector is basically theta by 360. You can see, this is the first thing I have written, 1/2, that is the fractional part, into the area of circle, that is pi r². Now, using this, we can find out these two also. If you talk about a semicircle, I just rub out these lines. Now, the angle which it forms, the semicircle, this straight line is forming is 180 degree. Now, if I put 180 here, this is 180 upon 360, and that is equal to 1/2. So, this is what we have the area of semicircle. Again, if I talk about the four equal parts, so this angle is basically 90. So, if I put 90 here, 90 by 360, it becomes 1/4. So this is what I have written, area of the quadrilateral. So, in general, we have the formula of area of sector as theta by 360 into pi r square, right? Then we talk about the area of segment. See, if I form a segment here, you can see clearly, this segment is basically the difference in the areas of the sector and the triangle which is formed in the middle. So, if I have to find area of segment, so area of segment would be equal to area of sector minus area of triangle which is formed in the center, right? And whatever the triangle will be there, accordingly we can apply the formula, right? Now, the next thing that comes is the length of the arc. Length of the arc. Again, what is arc? It is basically some part of the boundary of the circle, right? Some part of the boundary of the circle. So, if I say something like this, if I rub it out, say I talk about this portion. So this is some part of the boundary of the circle. So if I say half, if it is semicircle, if I say this one from here, so it will be, now when we talk about the complete length, this is 2 pi r. So length of semicircle, circumference of the semicircle, it will be half of the 2 pi r. If I talk about quarter circle, it will be 1/4 into 2 pi r. But again, I have to generalize to find the length of any part of the arc. So again, whatever the length of the arc I have to find, what we do basically, we join them in the center. Again, there is some angle being formed here. And from here, we can find the fractional part. This arc is of the circle. So, length of arc, we have the formula, length of arc is equal to theta by 360 into 2 pi r. So, this is the relation to find the length of the arc. Now, based on these relations, we will simplify the questions of exercise 12.2, right? So, let's start now exercise 12.2. Hello everyone, welcome to New Wave Coaching Classes for Mathematics. This is your host Jatin. Today we are going to continue our remaining questions of exercise 12.2. But before we start exercise 12.2, very important thing which we have discussed in the last lecture, there is some correction in that. In the last topic, I told you that the formula to find the area of triangle is 1 by 2 r square sine theta by 2. So this was the thing I told you. So you need to make a correction. This is not theta by 2. It is basically this thing. 1 by 2 r square sine theta. This is the area of any triangle whose angle, one angle is given to us, right? So you can use this. Now we start with the question number 7 of exercise 12.2, right? The solution is, I have already done on the board, you can see. Now in the question is given that the radius of that a chord which it subtends in the center is 120 degree, and the radius of the circle is 12 centimeter. Now what we have to find, we have to find here the area of the corresponding segment. So this is the area we have to find, which I have already shaded, and we have the formula: area of segment is equal to area of sector minus area of triangle. I have named the triangle and the sector. So since I have written sector, it means it is a complete OAB sector. Now to find the area of sector, we have the formula: theta by 360 into pi r square. And to find the area of triangle, we have the formula: 1 by 2 r square sine theta. We substitute the value. Theta is 120 by 360. In the question, it is given, we have to take the value of pi as 3.14. So we have taken 3.14. R is 12, so this is 12 square minus 1 by 2 into R, again 12 square minus sine of 120. Now you must be thinking that you learned about the values for the angles at 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90. What about 120? Don't worry, I am going to tell you what is the value of sine 120. You can learn it. But when you go in the higher class, you will come to know how to find the value of these angles also, which are greater than 90 degree, right? So at the moment, sine 120 is equal to root 3 by 2, right? So we substitute the value. This is 1 by 3 into 3.14 into 144 minus 1 by 2 into 144 into root 3 by 2. Now further, in the question, the value of root 3 is also given. So we have take, we will take the value of root 3 as 1.73. Now, to simplify this, again I told you the complication comes in this question for the simplification. So what I have done, I have taken 144 as common in this. So this is, what is left here? 3.14 upon 3. And on this side, root 3, that is 1.73 upon 2 into 2, that is 4. Now we take the LCM of these two. The LCM of these two comes out to be 12. So 12 is the LCM. So after taking the LCM, the first step is we divide the LCM by the denominator. So when we divide 12 by 3, we get 4. And then whatever the answer we get, we multiply it by the numerator. So we multiply 3.14 with 4 and we get 12.56. Then we divide 12 by 4, we get 3. And then we multiply this 3 with 1.73 and we get the value as 5.19. Right? Now we subtract these two. On subtracting, we get this as 7.37. This 12 gets cancelled with 144. And then simplifying, we get the answer as 88.44 centimeter square as the area of the segment. Right? Let's go to the next question now. And the next question is given that a horse is tied to a peg at one corner of a square shaped field. So let's make a square shaped field here. Now this is a square shaped field, and it is given that the side of the square is 15 meter. This is 15 meter given to us. Now it is given that at one end, at this end, a horse is tied with a rope, you can say, right? Now, when a horse is tied with some length of the rope, and if it moves, since one part of the rope is fixed, so when it moves, it will be forming something like this. It will form a sector basically. This one. Now, what is given to us? The length of the rope, this much. That will be equal to basically the radius of the sector which it is forming. In the angle, obviously, it will be 90 degree because it's in the square. Now, side of square is given to us. Side of square field is given to us 15 meter. Now,
length of rope is 5 meters. Now let's see the first part. They say the area of that part of the field in which the horse can graze. So what we have to find? We have to find the area of this portion. This portion area we have to find. Now since it forms a sector, the angle is 90 degree. You can also take as a quadrant, so it becomes 1/4. Or you can use 90 by 360. In both cases, you will get the same answer. So the area grazed by a horse will be equal to, you can write it as 1/4 pi r² because it forms a quadrant. Now we substitute the values. This is 1/4, right? The value of pi we have to take as 3.14. And the quotient is given 3.14, and r is 5, so we take 5 squared. So this is 3.14 into 25 upon 4. This comes out to be around 78.50 upon 4, right? And when we divide this, we get the answer as 19.625 meters squared. Now this is the first part. Now in the second part, what they was, they say if the length of the rope increases from 5 to 10, how much area more it can graze. So it means in the second question, what happens in the second part, basically what happens, the length of rope becomes this much. Now we have to find the area of this portion. Now that is increased area, right? Now new length of rope is given as 10 meters, right? So obviously the new area that can be grazed the formula will be same, but the difference will come in the radius. Earlier it was 5, now it is 10. So we write 1/4 into 3.14. 1/4 into 3.14 multiplied by 10 squared. So that comes out to be 314 upon 4. We get it as 78.50 meters squared. This is the new area. But what we have to find? We have to find the increase in area. So increase in area would be, increase in area, increase in grazing area, we can write it as, so that will be 78.5 minus 19.625, right? And when we subtract, we get the value as 58.875 meters squared, right? So this is the answer for the 8th question. Now let's see the 9th question. In the 9th question, it is given a brooch is made with silver wire in the form of circle with diameter 35 millimeter. The wire is also used in making 5 diameter which divides the circle into 10 equal sectors as shown in the figure. Now in the figure, it is given to us a brooch. A brooch is basically an item which is used on your suit. The coat which we wear, on that it is used. So it is given that this outer portion is made of silver wire, right? And with that, there are 5 diameters. This is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, and 5. These 5 diameters are also made of silver wire, right? Now the diameter of brooch is given as 35 millimeter.
Now, what we have to find here, the total length of the wire required, the total length.
So, the total length if we talk about, that will be equal to the circumference plus the length of 5 diameters. So this is 5 into D. So we have 2 into 22 by 7 into 35 plus, sorry, this is 35 by 2 because the radius is 35 by 2 plus 5 into 35, right? If you simplify this, so this is 110 plus 175 and this is 285 millimeters. Make sure units should be written correctly, because if you write the wrong units, the meaning changes. Right. Next thing what we have to find is the area of one sector. Now there are two ways. Either you find the angle for one sector, dividing 360 by 10 because there are 10 sectors, or since we know there are 10 equal parts, so one part will form 10th fraction, it means 1 by 10. So area of one sector would be 1 by 10 into pi r square, right? So just substitute the values and we can find the answer to this. So this is 1 by 10 into 22 by 7 into 35 by 2, 35 by 2 two times because it is r square. Let's cancel it out. So what we get is, this is 35 into 11, that is 385, and upon we have 4, and when we divide this we get it as, it goes by 9, it goes by 6.25 millimeter square. So that is the answer for the question number 9, 96.25 millimeter square. Let's see the next question now. Now in question number 10 is given, an umbrella has 8 ribs which are equally spaced. Assuming umbrella to be a flat circle of radius 45 cm, find the area between the two consecutive ribs of the umbrella. Now what is given, the ribs basically are the wires inside it, which help to open it. So if we make it in the form of a circle, it is given something like this. So there are 8 ribs and the length of one rib is 45 cm. Now we have to find the area of one part, this part, right? So we know there are 8 equal parts, so area of one part will be 1/8 of the area of the circle. So area between two consecutive ribs would be 1/8 pi r square. See, this way it becomes easy, because if you try to go and find the angle, then you have to find the angle first and then you substitute the value of angle to cancel out, the same thing comes. So minimize the calculation. So this is 1/8 pi r square, we substitute the values. This is 1/8 into 22/7 into 45 comes 2 times. So you just cancel it out. This is 4, this is 11. So this is 11 into 2025 upon 28, and when we multiply this, this is 5 and we have 7, it's 222 upon 28 centimeter square. So that's the answer, quite easy question. Let's go to the next question. It's given a car has 2 wipers which do not overlap. So you know, a car has a wiper, normally the cars have 2 wipers, so they move. So do not go 180 degree. So this is something, they come at some angle and they move. So the angle which they make from the beginning to the end is given as 135 degree. So in the 11th question, length of one wiper
Length of one wiper is given to us as 25 centimeters. And the angle made by one wiper is given as 115 degrees. Now, the area cleaned by a wiper, area cleaned by one wiper, obviously it goes from here and something like this, this way. So what it is forming? It is forming a sector, right? So we apply the area to find the, apply the formula to find the area of a sector. So this is 115 upon 360 into the value of pi, we take, okay, 22 by 7 only, it's not mentioned here. And into, this is 25 whole square. Now, this is the area cleaned by one wiper. But what we have? We are given two wipers. So, total area cleaned would be double of this. So, we multiply this by 2. So, this is 2 into 115 upon 360, 22 by 7 and 25 square, it would be 625. Cancel it out, this is 23 and in denominator it becomes 180, it comes out to be 72. So this cancels 36, then we have 18 and we have 11 and no more cancellation after this. So if you multiply in the numerator, this will be 158 and this will be 158, 125 upon, you multiply 18 by 7, it will be 126. So this is the answer. So if the values of the pi is given, then we have to obviously find the answer in the form of a decimal. It's not given, so we can keep it in the fraction only, right? Let's go to the next question, question number 12. Now in question number 12, what is given to us? Now in question number 12 is given, to warn ships for underwater rocks, a lighthouse spreads a red color light over a sector of angle 80 degrees to a distance of 16.5 km. Find the area of the sea over which the ships are warned. And lighthouse, basically we have discussed in the chapter of trigonometry, is basically to warn the ships that there is some mountain so they can change the direction so their ships do not collide with the mountains and they are saved, right? So what is given? The light of the lighthouse, obviously it is moving something like this and it makes an angle of 80 degrees. Obviously one side is fixed and the light is moving, it forms sector. And the length or the distance up to which it can go, it is given as 16.5 km. So distance up to which light from lighthouse goes is equal to 16.5 km. Right, in the angle form, is equal to 80 degrees. Right, now what we have to find? Area covered by the light. So obviously it forms the sector, so we apply the formula theta by 360 into pi r squared. Again, in this question also we have to take the value of pi as now in this question we have to take the value of pi as 3.14. So this is 80 upon 360 into 3.14 into 16.5 whole square. Right? Now just simplify this, cancel out 0. This goes by 4, 2, and this will be 9. So this is 2 upon 9 into 3.14 into, if we take the scale of 16.5, this will be, if we multiply it, this will be 16 so this is 272.25, right? This is what we get, 272.25, and then we can simplify this thing And when we simplify and find the value, we get the answer in approximation only. This is 189.97 kilometers square. So this is the area covered by the light of the lighthouse. Now let's go to the next question. That will be probably our last question of this exercise, because after this the question which is given is an MCQ type, right? So in the 13th question, there is some design of a table cover is given to us in the form of a hexagon. Let's make it out. Something like this. Right, so this is the design which is given to us. What else? It's given a round table cover has 6 equal designs as shown in the figure. If the radius of the cover is 28 cm, the radius of this cover is given as 28 cm. So if this is the center, from here this is 28 cm. Right? And if we join these two, so what we have, we basically have to find the area of one segment, right? And we have basically 6 segments, so we can find the area of 6 segments also. There's another way of finding the answer. We can subtract, see, this basically forms a regular hexagon. And the area of a regular hexagon is 6 into the area of an equilateral triangle. 6 times the area of equilateral triangle. So what we can do, if we need to find the area of design, we can subtract the area of circle and the hexagon. So these are the ways by which we can do it, right? Now if we have to find the area of one segment, so that will be area of sector minus area of triangle. So area of one segment, or we can also write it as area of design is equal to 6 times area of one segment. Now there are 6 segments basically, so obviously there will be 6 sectors. The sector and the angle formed by each sector would be equal, that will be 60 degrees. So we can write this as 6 into theta by 360 into pi r square minus, this is the area of sector minus area of triangle, or the triangle formed is an equilateral triangle. So this is root 3 by 4 into side square. Right, and the value of root 3 we have to take is 1.7. So this is 6 times, this is 60 upon 360 into 22 upon 7 into 28 square minus, this is 1.7 upon 4 into 28 square. Now this cancels out, comes out to be 6. Then we can write it as, we can just open the square. This is 6 into 1 by 6 into 22 by 7 into 28 into 28 minus 1 by 7 upon 4 into 28. Right? Now, there can be more ways to simplify this. So we do like this. This is, you cancel it out. And we multiply 6 inside. When multiply 6 with this, this 6 cancels here. So we are left with 22 into 4 into 28. And on the other side, this 6 also multiplies with this. So we have, this is 1.7 into 6 into 7 into 20. So this is what we get. Now we have to simplify this. We have to multiply these two things. Let's multiply it out now. So 28 into 4, it will be 112. 112 into 22 we have to do. So this is 22 into 112 minus 1.7. And this is 1.7 into 42.
into 28. So this will be, so multiplying this we get as 4, then we have 6, 4, 2, 2, 4, 6, 4, minus, multiply these two now, this is 42 into 28, it's 56, 512 plus 517, so 1176 into 17. So this is 29991. And we have decimal also, so this is something like this. 1999.2. And we subtract these two, we get 463. Let me check it out again once more. So we get it as 464.8 centimeter square. This is the area of the design. Now, but the question doesn't end here. Now, what is given in the next part? It's given the cost of making the design at the rate of 0.35 per centimeter square. We have to find the total cost. Cost of 1 centimeter square of design is given as 0.35 rupees, 0.35, right? Right symbol. So therefore, total cost for design is equal to 464.8 into 0.35. See, there can be variation while you do the simplification, right? So ultimately the answer comes out to be roughly, if you multiply this, 35 into 8 is basically 280. We have 28 carry, 35 4s are 140 plus 8 168, 16 carry, 35 into 6 is 210 plus 16 is 226, again 35 into 4 is 140 plus 22 is 162. Now we have the decimal also, so the decimals will be somewhere here. Three decimals, 1, 2, 3. So this is, so the actual cost comes out to be rupees 162.68. Alright, so this is the answer for question number 30. Now this was the last question, but the last question, there's one more question in which they have found, they have asked what is the area of sector of angle P of a circle with radius R. So you can obviously write the answer, it's quite simple. You can do it yourself. Right. So dear friends, this was all from my side. In this lecture, we have discussed the few questions which were left of exercise 12.2 using the formulas of area of sector, area of segment, length of arc. We have not done many questions for there. Right. So I hope you have understood everything. If not, just try to watch the video again. Make sure you like the video and subscribe to my channel. So this is your host signing off. Goodbye and take care.